Hey guys, welcome back. We've got a Model 12 here that's going to be getting restored. This has got it's going back, you know, white. There's of course the stain black here. It's got, you know, it's got some chips on it and things on it and everything, and they just want it to look like new. And of course, you know, the paint has got a little bit of, you know, discoloration just from age. The cord on this thing is extremely crunchy and extremely taped up, but the entire cord is wrapped in tape. So I'm not sure what's going to happen if I were to plug this in. But you only live once, right? Alright, it didn't blow a breaker, so that's a good sign. Alright, so it only runs on high, and it's making like a screeching noise in the back. So I'm going to say this thing is suffering from lack of lubrication and a bad capacitor. Possibly a bad resistor too, don't know. But I'm going to say that my guess is the capacitor is bad, it's got a dead short, and if we test it, it'll be dead shorted. So let's go ahead and start digging into this and see what's going on. Oh man, I'm worried I'm going to snap the screw clean off of here. Got her on a run, but still not convinced it's not going to snap. Something is cross-threaded here. There's absolutely no way this screw should be this tight. Getting easier now. Yeah, I don't know. It definitely looks rusty though. Yeah, boogered up the end of it there, so deal with that. Now you can see there's some flour built up in here. Make sure that one's centered on that. There's some flour built up in here, but it doesn't look too bad. I'm not sure why that was so rusty in there though. It's like really strange. Let's test some parts here. Let's see if I can pop this resistor out of there. Alright, looks awful black and corroded, and got a bubble on it right here. And it looks like, yeah, I don't know. Might be all right. Let's get some bare metal on here. that, we got a little bare metal showing. Make sure you guys can see that. Yep, that's showing. Alright, our resistor is actually good despite the fact that the finish is starting to come off and it's really dark on one side. It actually tests right at 180. So the resistor is good, but let's see if our capacitor is any good. And like I said, what it sounds like to me is a dead short, so that's what we're looking for. This thing beeps, we know. And nope. So the capacitor is good, and it's not leaking or anything. So that means we've got another issue where this thing is just running on high. So let's see if we can find out what it is. Let's take a look at the governor here. See, that's why I don't gamble, because I would have bet that it was the capacitor causing that thing to run on high like that. And then when you go and you test it and it's not dead shorted, I would have lost money. So if your money is valuable to you, don't gamble. Alright, let's get this governor out of here and see if we can see what's going on with this. For some reason, something is causing the speed to not change. So it's either going to be the governor or the pin that goes into the armature. And you can't really tell until I get this off. Okay, so the pin is obviously embedded in the plastic piece on the bottom of this governor, which means that it wore clean through it, and it's most likely bad. But now, I'm trying pop it off of here without pulling the pin out of the armature, because the armature I'm sure is still good. Yeah, it's really out there. Okay, so the pin is still, well, it's not really sticking in the armature well, but it had gone clean through this little plastic piece right there, bored clean through it, and it was just forcing this contact up there. But this is going to be an issue too, as this pin is supposed to be and it's supposed to stay in the armature, so we'll take a look at it once we get the armature out. So this one's got a couple issues right off the bat that's going to have to be taken care of. And I believe that this was a family machine as well, mother, grandmother, something like that. I don't recall exactly, but I think this was I think that this was definitely a family machine. So we definitely want to get it back up and running because it's got more sentimental value than anything else. This thing looks like it's been well taken care of. I mean, I don't know how heavily used it was, but if you look at the outside of it, I mean, it looks like it's been kept clean. And there's no oil or grease buildup down inside of here. Take a look under the gearbox here. Now I know why it was making that noise too. It was that pin was like I said, it was pushed right through that plastic piece, so that's what that extra noise was. That screeching noise it was making. Alright, let's look under here. Alright. The grease doesn't really look all that great. It's awful thick and sticky. Gasket looks good. Whoops. This is definitely some pretty bad grease in here. There's a lot of like rubbery chunks in it. It seems like it's started to dry out, when it separates, but I don't really see where oil would have ran out of it anywhere. I mean, normally when that happens, part of it, the oily part of it will just run out and run out of everything, and I don't see that anywhere in here. So that's kind of strange, but let's take a look at our brushes. All right. Yeah, I'm going to say this thing hasn't been used hardly at all because brushes still look like brand new as well. So it's strange that if it wasn't, it hasn't seen a whole lot of use, that pin would wear through that plastic piece on there. That definitely seems odd. This cord's got to go. cord weighs about three times what it should with all that tape on there. Curious about this part here now. So make sure this is okay. Yep, that's all right. I've seen them where it's worn right through, you know, this metal piece that goes down in here, making it look like a washer instead of a plate with a small hole in it. But this one seems good. Yeah, look at that armature. Aside from the, you know, the discoloration on there from the carbon brushes on it, I mean, I think it looks like a brand new armature. So yeah, this thing has very low miles on it. I am so surprised, you know, that governor pin wore through there like that. Let me see if this will reattach on here. I think if I can find the slot where it goes, I think I can get that to reattach on there. There we go. We've got that reattached. I'll have to check it again later just to make sure it's going to stay. Alright, let's get this little detent out of here, the spring. You gotta remember, we're stripping this one down completely because it's getting powder coated. Oh, that's interesting. This detent pin does look different, but it's also got a washer that sits on top of it. I've never seen one of these with a washer on it before. It's funny, when you do enough of these, you occasionally run into stuff that's different. Alright, this one's got a couple areas where it seems to hang up. I mean, it doesn't feel like there's a lot of drag on it, but you can tell there's some spots where it wants to hang up. So there's definitely some goop on these shafts in here. But judging by the fact that this thing hasn't been used a lot, and it's probably been sitting for a long time, it's pretty amazing that these aren't seized up. Fortunately, I've got these governor assemblies. I've got a few of these laying around, so I can go ahead and actually replace it. As a matter of fact, I've got a couple that were actually tweaked too, and I'm wondering if I cut that plastic piece out of there, or drill that out of there, if I can cut one of them apart to get the plastic piece out, because it looks like it just, like it's got prongs on the other end, and they snap when you push in, or just replace that plastic tip and still reuse this governor, because I'm sure the contacts on this thing are still good. Can't see them because I got a shroud over them, but I'm sure that they're good. Alright, let's see about getting these shafts out of here. Alright, there's one. Yeah, it looks like this part up here looks good. Now, you can see it does got varnish on it. I mean, it feels dry, but I can kind of dull it with my fingers. Same with this down here. Feels dry. It is varnished up. I think it's just luck that this thing didn't seize up, because there's definitely a layer of varnish on those. Same with this one. I mean, they're absolutely varnished up. Any other machine that would have, any other one of these that would have, you know, this thing, they would be seized in there and we'd be having a tough time getting them out. I think we got lucky on this one. Alright, that's cleaned up good enough for now. Take this cover off here and get rid of our cord. Where I have nice long leads on there. That's what I like about these Model 12, is they've got nice long leads on the motor there. Alright, now I gotta get this fuel coil out of here, so I will be right back. Alright, fuel coil's out. Now, not much left on this here, just brush holders, and then the pin on the bottom. Here's one, looks a little oily. And this does that one. But those are out, and all I gotta do is just knock that pin out of there. And then of course on here, I take these feet off to replace them, but take this apart so that we can take this off and knock our parts out of here. So, I'm not going to do that on camera because it's that's pretty, you know, blah. You guys have seen it a bunch of times before. But anyways, I'm going to go through and get this stuff all blasted and powder coated, and all the other parts will be cleaned and polished up, and then we'll come back and we'll get everything put back together. Got this one wrapped up now, and we did go and get the pin secured, the pin on the end of the armature that goes in there that pushes up against the flyweights. We got that secured back on there. That wasn't really too difficult. And what was the other thing? Oh, the little plastic piece on the back of the governor. I was able to actually take an old one apart, an old governor that I had, take it apart and get the plastic piece out, and then I just cut the plastic piece out of the speed control on here. I just cut it right off of there and was able to pop the new one in there. So then the original parts were able to be reused in there, especially the armature. That was the one I really wanted to be able to reuse because the armature was in such good condition on here. It's hard to believe that it could have, that pin. I know what pulled the pin out. It went through that plastic piece and got stuck in there. So then when the flyweights went back, it just popped it out of there. But it's hard to believe that thing would have worn through that quickly, considering this mixer didn't look like it really had a whole lot of use. I mean, even when it came in here, it was overall in really good shape. There was, a little bit of chipping and stuff like that. But now we've got it looking like brand new, and it's working again just like it's supposed to. So let's go ahead and fire this thing up and give it a listen to. guess it sounded like something must have gotten bumped a little bit when I put it back together there. I had to take the cap apart off again and put the heat shield for the resistor on, which I found laying over there. So it sounds like it needs another quick adjustment here. Sounds much better. Now we put the cap back on. Now I noticed before when I had it together before, it had all its all 12 speeds. The last two there, you could tell the difference between them when you switch. So just wanted to, I knew it was capable, so I wanted to get it back to that. Some of them, when they're worn out, they lose that capability, but this one did not. So anyways, this is a wrap. We're going to give it a final wipe down. It didn't come in with a turntable or beaters or nothing like that. It was just just the parts that need to be redone. But we're going to get this one wiped down again and get the video uploaded here, and then we'll get it back to the owner and get it home. If you guys have any questions or comments, send them down below and I will get to those as soon as I can. If you have any or if you liked the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and let me know that you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe and click that little bell down there next to the subscribe button, so that you can get notified whenever we post new videos. We got some interesting things coming up here. We've got, I don't even know off the top of my head. I can't recall, but I know we've got some interesting mixers coming up. I know you guys see a lot of Hamilton Beach and mainly a lot of Sunbeams, but we do got some different things coming up. So you want to subscribe to be notified for that. And appreciate you guys watching. As always, we will see you on the next one.